Come on. Thanks for coming. That's my presentation. If you don't know, now you know it. The title is There and Back Again, which is the title of The Hobbit. So it tells about a story. So I'm also, as Derek said, I'm a freak or a geek or whatever. I like these things too. So I liked it. So and I'll use it to tell you my story. A small index. I've just divided the presentation in three blocks: the past, what I did, what I'm doing now, the present, and what I would like to do, because it's a would like. I don't know if it will happen, but let's see. I'll give you some ideas of what I think that should be done. So, once upon a time, I used to be an innocent hobbit. I was young, small, and
you have hairy feet.
Also, and I live in the Shire. It was my comfort zone, my small town. I didn't know anything from the outside, and I didn't know about the dragons and balrogs and demons and orcs that were outside of the Shire. So I was happy, basically. A hobbit, well, not really a hobbit. I studied engineering with my friend Carlos here. I said I studied because, as I'll tell you later, I didn't finish, like him. But well, I studied engineering in Seville. But this helped me to end up here.
Oh, hard.
Here's where everything started. There was a few people doing a collaborative portal for our school, for our engineering school, for all the students to share the materials, the ideas, solutions, everything related to our career. And it was made with, well, this is not the first version, actually, right, Carlos? I think the first one was with pure HTML, maybe,
yeah,
or something
like
that.
It was a phone service with no login.
Bullshit, basically.
Yeah.
So, but this is where I joined. They had, I think it was around 2003, and it was built with PHP Nuke, which is what you're seeing here. It was, I must say, it was very useful. You could really do things with this and share stuff, so it was very good, and it got some traction between students, and most people in our school use this portal, so I started getting more involved. Around 2005, we had evolved a bit after some problems with PHP Nuke, for evident reasons, and we ended with Mambo and with Simple Machines Forums integrated, which is what you see in the middle, and this was the Mambo version of the portal. And what happened in 2005, I'm sure you all know that the split from Mambo and Joomla was born, so we had to migrate the, well, we didn't have to, but we thought it was a good idea, we liked it, and we moved to Joomla, and this was around 2005. That was the beginning of everything, right? So I started using Joomla because of that portal, year after year, doing some personal websites for my friend's football team and all these things. And I started using it as an end user, slowly. By the end of 2007, I used it a lot. We used it a lot. I see we, because Carlos is here, and this story was from 2003, more or less. It was, we were together in all this stuff. So around in June 2008, we created this blog. We called it Gnumla. The idea was to make it sound like Gnumla with the Spanish letter ñ, which is more or less the same sound as gnu, but not gnu, it's new. In Spanish, the animal is a new. So, but we didn't succeed. With many names we've created, we didn't get what we wanted, but well, Since 2008, we started sharing, because there was, by that time, there was nothing in the Spanish community. We were doing a lot. We were getting more involved everywhere, and we thought we had the need to share all that with the Spanish speaking community. And I must say it was quite successful, the blog. We got many readers. I think that in the best times, maybe we had like how many visits a day? 500? 1,000?
But you have to say that it started being successful since you took the lead.
A what?
Since you took the lead, it started being successful.
Okay, thank you, Carlos. Anyway, it was great. We were still hobbits by that time, right? We were happy. There were no dragons. We still in more or less in the surroundings of the Shire. This was still fun. So we wanted more. Also in 2008, we both became
2009. 2010 after the
IPO. No, it was before.
It was after first the IPO.
Okay, so forget the date there. Whatever, okay, so then I'll move to 2009. I'm sure you know this one too. we did it together. I think it was our first real commercial Joomla job. I mean real, because we did some smaller things, smaller websites, paid. Don't take this, but probably without invoice. I mean, it were this kind of small stuff. Not this one.
Everything we did was with invoice.
Okay.
Everything that was involved with you, there were invoice. I don't know what you mean on the back, but.
Okay, I was trying to catch you. Okay, me too. Never without invoice. Okay. It's okay. So. Then it was before the forums. Some of you will remember this, JPeople, the Joomla People portal. To me, it meant a lot. It was really where I jumped from a random occasional involvement to a more stable involvement with Joomla. I think it was a great idea. It had a very poor implementation. We fought, the people who were behind it, we fought a lot to try to make it better and make it successful, but we found tons of problems from all kinds. This was Jom Social, a very early version of Jom Social, very customized. For anything we wanted to do, we needed to come with the lead programmer of from Jom Social, so we couldn't really make it evolve the way we wanted, because we had to wait for him for any small step. We had to wait to know if we could touch this or that, so this was a stopper. But also by that time there was a big, at least the first big fight that I've lived in the community. It's the time from Molayo, Nuku, all together as a whole, all this arise. And there were big discussions, and probably you won't believe it, but before Twitter and Facebook, people used this, and the fight took place mostly here. So there was a big pressure over our shoulders, over the people who were involved here, because there were some big rants and flame wars here, but I think it was great because it was happening in a community property. It was ours. It was there. Everything was public. It was there, but for many reasons it failed. Oh well, I forgot this one. This was in 2011. You can read it. Really there, but it was in May 2011. It was my first official, besides the forum moderator, local forum moderator, my first official position, title, whatever, was JAB People Communication Manager. It really did a lot, just the badge, by that time. So I think that's something I've learned from this. Badges matter, are not the only thing that matter, or you shouldn't focus on badges, but they matter. Just to people who are getting involved, they help making people more involved and feel that they get appreciated. So that's why I included this, because it was important to me to decide spending more of my free time with Joomla instead of, I don't know, football, for example, or whatever. I really liked it, so I spent more time on it. And then this came. First JAM Beyond, it was, I don't know, what was the title of your talk? Joomlifying the world? So I got Joomlified here. It was the first one, because this was before the JAB People Communication Manager, 1 year before. This is what put me in perspective what Joomla, the community, meant. I mean, you can see this picture in any JAM Beyond. It's been the same since 2010, since the first one. Food, love, probably a few less kilos, but or maybe not. I don't know. Who cares? It woke me up. It doesn't have to do. This is Brian, the young Brian by that time. I put it because of the title of that talk, Waking Up the Neighborhood. It woke me up. It was great. These events are important in Joomla. They matter. They get people to do things and to participate and to get involved in the end, which is, I think, what matters here. Then it came the second edition, which was another jump. It was like going high year after year. This was important, actually, very important, because it went from not a hobby, because by that time I was already doing freelancing work as integrator, basically, as a Joomla integrator. But I met these two lovely people who are here in a great place. I love this picture with Sigrid there inside the. And I met them there. I think I was contributing by that time with the translations, because by that time I contributed all my free time to anything. I did translations for Fireboard. Do you remember the
Fireboard? Yeah.
Fireboard before Kunena, then with Kunena, Remositore, Sobi Pro, Akiba. We did, I think, all translations we found that were possible. We did the translations. I was already contributing, but I met you, got to know you in this event. So, as it was shown later, it was great, because 1 year later I started working with you. So, and it's been a few years that, I mean, for me, working from home with Joomla, with people I'm comfortable working, it's been a great experience. So for me, it was, and it happened in JAM Beyond. So attending two events once again, it's important. But besides then, which was the key one, but I got to know a lot of more people in the community. I think that there is when we paid David, not David,
Peter.
When we paid Peter to get us in the moderator team,
we paid
the beers, and we said, okay, so we are moderator. No, not really. It was great. I had thousands of pictures from that event with lots of people that
can
I met.
Can you remember what you ate that night?
A what?
What you ate that night? That is the last day of the event, I think. So.
The, not the one in the middle, the other two, yeah, we had a kebab.
Exactly.
The best kebab I ever had. In the, it was in
Arnhem.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was great. But also it was my first talk in English in Joomla, our first talk actually. In
what, you took the lead again, and I was like saying what I do in the events.
That it was called Hola Mundo, or why should your Joomla-based extension or business speak Spanish? We were doing translations for everything. Anything that was Joomla and had a translation, we said, hey, can we help?
So. There is a typo in the title, the Spanish should be abrogated.
Okay.
Busted.
Completely. Okay, so it kept going high. Again, after JM Beyond, in August, I joined the CLT. There were positions open. I got nominated. I think I nominated myself.
No, you asked me to nominate
you. No, I had some, besides me, I had some people. Well, no, actually it was.
Because I think you could only be nominated by community. I think you cannot propose yourself.
No, you could. It's been like that. But now that you say that, we got together, Guillermo and me, to say, okay, we would like to go together, so we get someone from Latin America and from Spain, so we have the Spanish community, Spanish-speaking community represented in the leading part of Joomla. But in the end, I got in and Guillermo knows, so I just forgot about Guillermo forever. He had done his job, no. I got in, but well, Guillermo got in later, and he's still in CLT, if it exists already, still CLT. I'm not sure in which point we are the transition or whatever. So, well, it was in August 2011, and this was the higher step in involvement, because it really takes a lot of time. If you take it seriously, it takes a lot of time. Sometimes I failed to do stuff, well, because of I'm human and I'm not perfect, but other times because of time. There's no time to do things as good as it takes. So, well, from there, it started, as I said, my biggest involvement, and I continued attending JM Beyond, meeting more people, doing more stuff, but since, I think for me, this was the peak of being a happy hobbit, right? I started knowing the orcs, and maybe dragons also, and wargs, and all the beasts out there. We started having a very, very hot discussions at meetings, because of, well, by that time there was people wanting to change the Joomla structure, because they thought that all the problems that Joomla had were in the structure. It happened already in 2011 or 2012, I can't remember. And since there, it's been like repeating again until finally it looks like we are inside a restructured process, which has been going for maybe 2 years now. We still have nothing, so to me it proves that it was the wrong way to go. We'll see what happens later. So, I mean, happy hobbit, top of happy hobbit here, not anymore. So, well, I don't mean I didn't have fun or enjoy what I did. I enjoyed it a lot. I tried to give my best. I got involved in several areas. The showcase, we made a first attempt of the template directory. Oh, Carlos, come on. Okay, here's the nomination. of Carlos, his email to nominate me for CSD, okay? It's been recorded. Thank you.
And you nominated Guillermo, I have it.
Ah, okay, okay. So you are like a Joomla archaeologist, right? You have all the missing pieces.
I'm surprised the screenshots you are showing because I couldn't have found a way of showing them. So the Comuna.
The other ones.
The other ones.
I took the screenshots like 10 years ago and I have them yet in my. Digital Diogenes syndrome. Yeah. Okay, so as I said, I got involved in more areas. The first Joomla template directory attempt, which finished in nothing. We also tried to make Joomla people a real community portal, joining community.joomla.org, creating something similar to what volunteers.joomla.org is today. This was back in 2011, 2012. We didn't succeed. I say we because it was mainly led by Sandra Warren. She was in charge of JPeople's site, and I worked very well with her, and we tried to do that. We had a plan, we had contacted people to do the work, but as many things in Joomla, it ended up in nothing. Sadly, because, we are in 2016, and we have a volunteer portal, which has some nice features, but it's a fraction of what it should be, at least in my opinion, for a community site, for a volunteers portal for Joomla. So, well, it was sad. So, more involvement, more discussions, more stuff, until 2015 we had this surprise. For me it was a surprise because it was not planned to raise the need of a structure change, but it happened during JAM Beyond. So in the end we had lots of discussions, we tried to stop it, but in the end, in May 2015, I stepped down from CLT, and I've made these screenshots because I'm really proud of what people wrote here, because Ruth and Sarah and Javier are people who I never, but in this point we didn't agree at all in what we had to do. But when I resigned, all what they say is that Ruth says, thanks for all the passion you bring to your involvement with the project and for standing by your values, even when it was difficult to do so. Sarah says the same, I agree with you, I appreciate it that you stood by your values. So to me that means that I did the right thing. I mean, I stand for my values, I'm here for that. I think that even if it's not the most popular or it's not what people perceive as the right thing. I mean, you don't have to be as stubborn just because of the sake of it, but stand up for your values and defend them. And if you fail, I feel that I fail because we are in this structure change, I just step down and let others in and see if they can do it, okay? At least in this part, in this position. So this is basically my past story since I started like a happy hobbit until I came back to the Shire after carrying the ring for a few years. It was heavy, and by this moment I was mostly burnt. I got bitter about Joomla stuff. I was not collaborating anymore in things which were in the top level Joomla community, so it was like a relief for me. I just resignated and went away for a few months, too many years, I like Joomla, so I started doing stuff again, and here's where it comes here now. What am I doing now? In the official part of Joomla, I'm mostly spending my time in documentation, specifically translation. I've written, contributed content to some articles, but it's mostly translation for a while. Lately, there's a guy from Argentina, I think it's him, Adrián Argüelles, who is doing most of the translations. But well, that's where I spent most of my time. But I got focused mostly on the local community. We've done several Joomla days in Spain, here in Spain. Local Joomla days, it was something different that it took a bit to get people's mind used to that change, because the structure of the official structure of Joomla says that only one Joomla Day event per country, per year, that's it. But what if people is demanding events? Maybe they don't want a 3 days event, they just want a Joomla event, just to show up and one day. And it's great, and it's been working. Well, we have here this beautiful lady who is from Logroño. Well, not from Logroño, but lives in Logroño. It's a small city in the north of Spain. They have never had a Joomla Day. We had the first one three years ago. She met us there, and 3 years later, she's here. JM Beyond and getting more involved, so it works. It's the proof that it works. These events, why getting limited to one single event when we can go to different places, if there's people willing to do it, if we can fund it, if Joomla can help, because actually for Logroño we had help from the local government, but also from Joomla. It was our only sponsor, Open Source Matters. So it's good for a small amount. We are moving Joomla everywhere. Because
it's more than 100 people in Chile.
Oh. Yeah. It's like, between 100 and 110, more or less, during three consecutive years in the same small city. So it's great. And we've also made one in Malaga, in Seville, from where I come. And right now we are trying to push some of the other Spaniards which are here to make others in Vigo, maybe in Granada. Leave your smartphone. Granada?
Sorry.
No. But well, Granada, right? Okay. Hopefully. I want to go to Granada. It's a beautiful city. So, Joomla, Granada. So,
Granada, it's great. Will happen this year.
November.
Oh, you see, they are now fighting just for who organizes it where. So it works. So this year we made all this, we helped organizing, co-organized or completely organized all these Joomla days. But each time it was one new website and starting from scratch, and then let's build the form. Every year it was the same work. And all the job, all the work and all the content generated got lost after the event. So this year Juanca decided, because he's been the one who has built the websites for these events, mostly, he decided, okay, I'm tired of
just like
doing again the same, reinventing the wheel. So we created this project, which is basically a hub for community staff in Spain. As we are moving and doing all these events, we want to have this site, and our plan is to have there all the events with the slides, the speakers, the speakers directory, recordings directory of all the videos of the conferences. But we would also like to get people from user groups have a common place to get listed, or I mean a place where people can start doing Joomla. But as I talk you later, our intention is not being the Joomla site in Spain, the Joomla community in Spain. It's just one project, that if you like how we work, okay, come and join us and let's do things together. But if you don't like, that's great. We don't pretend being the only one, which is, in my opinion, one of the mistakes that the Joomla project has made towards community in the last years, which is trying to regulate everything, trying to make it to make everything upside down, like a pyramid, hierarchical. So this is an experiment right now, but it looks it's working. So maybe we could replicate it in other places. And this is the other thing I've been doing. I've been a bit more disconnected in the last few months because of job and personal stuff. But I'm still there for the moment. We'll see if I have time in the future. But JUMGAUTS is a community project. We're basically doing a live hangout every 2 weeks in Spanish, and inviting people from the community, mostly from the Spanish community, but we had Soren in English from Component Creator, and we had Daniel Canche from SiteGround a couple of years ago talking about their infrastructures, and we have, I think, like 17 programs, yes. 80 programs? Like 100 hours of video about Joomla, and we do it more or less every 2 weeks, but sometimes we have to move because of lack of time or holidays or whatever. But it's a community project that has worked very well. When we go to the Joomla days, people tell us, I know you from JUMGAUTS. Not from anywhere else. They say, I know you from the programs. So it has worked very well, and it's another thing that we have done alone, outside of the official staff. We want to do Joomla, we do Joomla. And people really love it. We try to provide the documents that we use during the programs. We try to provide them to download, so people can not also see the program, but also they get the material if they want to investigate further. Okay, so that's what I'm doing now, but how about the future? Well, that here is where, from here, there be dragons, that was in the maps, right? First of all, it's a small idea that I have of where should Joomla go in general. This is very philosophical, very, I don't know, in the air, smoke, but call it whatever, but this is what I think, so I think it's a good moment to just put it in a slide and tell about it briefly. Well, the CMS market is not what it was 10 years ago, everybody knows about this, and we are trying to find our place, but I think that we should maybe focus on things that matter to people. Back in 2005, it was important having a platform that was easy for implementing websites. Nowadays, there are hundreds. So it's not important anymore. It's okay that we are like that, but it shouldn't be our main goal. I think privacy is something that matters to end users. And for example, do you know the Brave browser, which has been released a couple of months ago in a beta or something like that? It's a browser that basically kills all external connections to ad sellers, or not only ads, but also social networks, mm-hmm. Facebook. Basically, it's based, they sell privacy. Mm-hmm. Then they can insert their own ads with their partners or whatever, but it's having a great success because people is interested in privacy. People, and from an open source project, I think we should focus on that, because what can we offer to people? We're not the big ones. We should offer this kind of stuff. Also, it's connected to that data ownership. we live in the cloud more and more, but what with your data? You don't own your data. If you create a Facebook group, your data is there. If Facebook changes its conditions, all this data goes away. So it's something we can offer, installable. You own your data. I think it would be also a good idea. The third one is really what we've been doing since 2005, which is democratizing the internet publishing. I think we also should focus on hostings, because hostings are usually seen as the vultures flying around a hobbit's project, which is we are happy and we don't want nothing commercial. No, we should work with them, because the big ones are starting to offer what they offer. I mean, they are offering groups, or build your page inside Facebook, or build your group in Google Plus. So we should work together with hostings, and also mobile. The mobile world is here, so we should focus on apps or hybrid applications or whatever. But I think it's just an idea, just to leave it there. But now, getting focused on what we have now in the Joomla project, I think we've been doing wrong. We've been just heading, or people just have been thinking that there's a single way of reaching success, but there are different ways. And now it comes the way I'm wearing my football team shirt. This is one way to success, which is Real Madrid. Their president, anybody who doesn't know about Real Madrid or football,
go out.
Okay. Now, well, it's the most the team that has the most tournaments in the world. Basically, it's the most successful in terms of titles or tournaments won ever. So, and this is from 2014. They had a model, their president had a model that was called Zidanes and Pavones. Zidane was a big star, a very expensive player, and Pavon was a player from their lower teams, which was free for them. They just had to train him and rise him to the first team, but in the end, this didn't work. And they end up just paying the most expensive players, and they get into their team. And it's a way to success, apparently, because they won the biggest tournament in Europe, probably in the world, which is the Champions League. They won it in 2014. You also have Barcelona, which won the year later, last year. They have a different model. They have their training place. It's called La Masia. So they train players since they are very young. They go to other places. So they bring talent, since people is very small, and they train them. They try to make them play as they want. And in the end, they have very good players that came at no cost. No cost compared when you hire them from the outside, but also they pay big amounts for big players. So it's another model that leads you to success. But this is the Wise Mix, which is my team. It's absolutely smaller than the other two. Their budget, the yearly budget, is like 8 times smaller than the others. And they can hire top players, so they have to adapt and get the most out of everything they have. So this could be what Joomla is. You could see Barcelona and Madrid like Real Madrid like Drupal or WordPress, because of the money they have. They can pay talent. They have people working in Automatic or Acquia. you won't see this in Sevilla because there's no money for top players, for big talent. So it's kind of what we have in Joomla. We must find other ways to reach success. And I think we should take more care of the community and try to get people from there and make this attractive for people to come in without paying them, which was suggested, by the way, in some leadership meetings, but I completely disagree with that for Joomla. But I also think we need to rethink the ecosystem. This is the main idea I want to transmit with this talk, or this part of my talk. Right now we have kind of centralized structure. You have the official project, and if you don't get your idea or your whatever inside or accepted by the official project, it's burnt. It doesn't count, and there's a lot of people who have tried to contribute that hit a wall when they tried to get the idea inside the official staff. And these people who were willing to contribute, who were willing to do stuff, just not only weren't able to contribute, but they got angry, and in some cases they tried to harm the project. So this is crazy. So we don't have money. It's not like an employee who has way. We need to attract people. If people is willing to contribute, we should lower the barrier for contribution. We should make it really easy to contribute, to get inside, or at least it should be very easy for Joomla to get the outcomes of what people want to do, right? Which is not the same as getting them inside the community or the project or the infrastructures, which is what we've been trying to do. If someone wants to do something, okay, let's make a work group, let's have an open discussion in Google Groups, let's have a meeting, let's have a team leader, let's see if we are under PLT or CLT or whatever, when we just want an outcome. Okay, I want to do this, like JoomGout, the project that I showed before. We wanted to do it, we did it, it's there. If the Joomla project would like to do something with that, it would be great, just tell us. If not, I don't mind. I mean, I'm having fun with what we're doing, so that's what we are doing that. And we should change, I don't know exactly to which model we should change, but definitely not a centralized one. People who want to do something should be able to do something without anything else. Then, of course, there should be filters to determine what ends up in the official stuff, but as long as they do, and what they do is public, and people can benefit from it, that's great, they just do it. We're doing that also with the community here. Actually, Joomla S, the other project we are doing here, it's trying to do something like that. We want to be like a hub for, as I said before, for things around Joomla here in Spain. In this new structure, I think the key concept are independent nodes. All the nodes in that network that I showed before should be independent. They should be able to work. The outcomes, or there should be open data outcomes, so the community can and the project can get benefit from it, reusable stuff. This third point probably should be on top. Teams of friends. One of the most frustrating experiences I've had in Joomla is loving to work in something in Joomla and getting a few people joining this team who I don't work together well. It's frustrating. So it's the model that we're having with Juanca, or that I had with Carlos. We had an idea, we wanted to do it, we worked very well together, so we did it. I think this is a key concept to change our minds there. And I think I'm getting very close to my time. Okay, so I'll go a bit faster, it's not much left. Lead by example, lead by doing. You want to do something, do it. Stop shouting or complaining or ranting about that I can't or CLT won't accept this or PLT won't accept that. Just do it. We have GitHub, we have websites. Just do it in the open, and if it works, if it's good, people will get it, will get it, will adopt it. Also, do not try to fix something at all levels. As I said now, many times when someone has an idea, it happened yesterday here in Jay feedback session by Joe Campbell. He said, okay, he writes some ideas, and he said, okay, let's write something, and let's see if we can get together or make a work group. That's our idea. We want to fix it at community level. We have an idea, how can I implement this for all Joomla? No, just do it locally, small, limited by the time and the energy and the resources you have, and do it. As I said before, lower the barrier for contributing and care about volunteers and cooperators. So to me, the official Joomla project role in this structure should be primus inter pares, which is what the Romans called to their emperor, which is the first one among equals. That means all the nodes are equals. They are doing their stuff, and they interact as equals. It's not as you are part of a hierarchical structure and I'm the boss and okay, I want you to do this, or do it the other way, have a veto power. Okay, you've been working for 2 months on this, but I'm the one who accepts this, so I don't want it. No, it should be a one-to-one relationship where everybody is the same. It should act as a facilitator, keep the infrastructures, provide resources to people who want to do things, even fund the good ideas to help them rise. Also should act as a connector between the different teams, the different nodes, because sometimes people start doing something and they don't know that someone else is doing something similar, so they should act as connectors. Of course, they should care about the trademark, defend and promote the trademark, and maintain the official infrastructures, and last but not least, gather and document all the community knowledge. Sometimes a lot of work has been put in some areas of the project. Someone just got angry and all that knowledge went away. Or we started a project like JPeople, and all we put in JPeople, once it failed, all this knowledge has gone. It should be a role of the Joomla project to have a database or a wiki like we have. Actually, we have the forums and the documentation that are acting as documentors of this community knowledge, but it should be something more active. So just in some, you have this. What happens? Yeah, it's Apple. It's a nice slogan. Think different. I would say care different, because it's when we are burnt. I've been burnt for a while. You say I don't care anymore. I don't care. But the fact is that I do care. But I want to care different. Don't say okay. I don't want to have nothing to do with the Joomla project anymore. So. No, just, okay, I'll do it my way, and if people like it, it will be great. I will remember this again, the different approaches. Today, I see that I didn't do my best when this arose. I was in neglect. I didn't want, I just saw this and I said, oh, it goes against the project. But they had some valid ideas. I still believe that in most of it, it was not the right way, and I would still tell them, but probably the attitude should be different, because there were some valid points in this project, or also Molayo. There were valid points. If we had this different structure, where each node produces outcomes, it would have been great. So that the Joomla project would have taken the good part of it instead of just getting into the trenches and shoot at each other, making damage, harming each other that happened. So different approaches to the same stuff shouldn't be this, but rather a new hope. Mm-hmm. Not the Phantom Menace. You say, oh look, they are doing a fork of this part, or there's a portal with templates or extensions. It's a different approach. They probably tried to do it inside the Joomla, the official project, but they weren't allowed, they couldn't, whatever. Now they're doing it, they're maintaining it, they're doing the job. It's not a menace, it's a new hope. It's you can get good stuff from there. So it's almost time for this. Let the force awaken. Let's do it all way. And when there's no way to work together, may the force be with you. But in a community sense, I mean, in any sense, right now we are very the few times that we have forked the community, like in all together as a whole, it was more a place to rant about what was wrong or some valid points, but in general it was that, and there was not a culture that this was good. And I'm not talking about code. We are an open source project. Forks should be a good thing, but I'm talking about community. So I'm almost my time, so. This is from JM Beyond 2012, I think, so thanks. That was it.